NBA. They led the NBA last year at better than 100 points per game. Settle back and enjoy it as we get to the hoop on Fox Sports Net. Bruce Alexander, Hank Armstrong, Joe DeRosa all set to officiate. And we're on go here at the go. And Schroeder is quickly in a hurry. Kings, however, Bobby Divac and Chris Webber are capable of blocking shots. Williamson got inside, got his own put back in the roll of home. Willis Williamson, who averages 11 points per game and shoots 48%. However, on the road, they do not work quite as much as they do at home. They're a much poor defensive team. Smart Bryant going baseline. On Lamon Murray. Murray's going to tee up a triple to go. From home run range, and the Cavaliers on the board quickly. Jason Williams. Chris Webber not adverse to shooting the three either. Lamon Murray's got a strip away, and Brevin Knight is safe. Webber taking a spill over in that first row, so Murray's going to cross the timeline.
Lamon Murray has had problems with inbound passes. He's one for two tonight.
Mark Bryant is going to get whistled for a push. And that'll come on Lottie Divac. So his front line now, Divac, Williamson, Webber. A little bit of everything. They'll mix and match, and they all obviously can bring different aspects of the game that will give you trouble.
And Lottie Divac, Chris Webber, very comfortable at going out on the perimeter, which gives a lot of openings to Corliss Williamson. And that's, I'm a little surprised that Nate Williamson not taking advantage of that.
On the repost to Divac with a jump rim over the top of Kemp into Sean's hand. Cavaliers by seven, and with it they have tripled three times here in the opening minutes. Brevin Knight, that dotted line jumping, rattled and fell. And Brevin Knight did go for backward. That's a tough little shot, that little in between 7-8 footer. And many times, even if you are handling, it's best to use the backward. We're watching for error. That's exactly what happened for Brevin there. He's got the roll. Well, you can get mesmerized. Watch it, Jason Williams. He's going to miss everything with that line. Stuck it. This is Chris Webber. That rally. Sora and Bryant left it for Nick Anderson. Well, this team will take a lot of bad shots, and Chris Webber very comfortable out on the perimeter launching jump shots. So Jason Williams put up that air ball. He's shooting 28%. He never developed that low post game where he can draw double teams and then become a passer for his teammates. Get a good shot.
Cavaliers have hit five straight field goal attempts after missing their first couple. Lamon Murray has popped out.
Going to lift it over to Corliss Williams.
I got it.
Front rim with a jumper into the hands of Chris Webber. Webber at 6'10". Bring the basketball up the floor. Carried it twice. Jason Williams going into his reversing on the baseline. He's so good with either hand. On the block here on Nick Anderson. As he's been So far brutalized by Bob Sura with the three-pointers. Jason Williams able to drive in there. He's so good with his either hand and a hard dribble. He's got a very hard dribble. Constantly the ball comes up into his hand so quickly that he's able to control the ball somehow.
Not a flash and dash to his game. Bob Sura fought about it. The short cap and back out of there. Now they lift the number three. Divac kept Mark Bryant off the offensive glass. Three boards for Bryant. Chris Webber inside. Chris Webber to pound it down.
That was an excellent pass by Jason Williams. Just an alley-ooper, just threw it high in the air, letting Webber beat the smaller shooter.
Divac short gets his hand. None of that.
Winners, and he's not shooting them well. Abysmal from the line. He's only taken 13 free throws all season long. He doesn't want to go in there and get fouled. So his game is in total disarray.
That left block. This is Sean Kemp with a step through, and Kemp with a little resistance from Chris Webber.
Chris Webber is not that poor a defensive player as he should have been. He doesn't want to get the foul.
Bombs away from Jason Williams. He splashes a long three. Jason only a 28%er from home run range.
That air ball a couple minutes ago.
Uh-huh.
That really discouraged him.
Mark Bryant from the baseline. Mark Bryant will lace the jump in. Mark Bryant. Told him last night, pros pro, knows how to play the game.
It's solid. Just gives you the same kind of effort, just about every night, same kind of stats.
Chris Webber has dropped a triple, and Chris Webber has a 10-point beginning through the first 6 minutes of this quarter.
He's actually their best three-point shooter percentage-wise. He's now 8 for 16 on the year.
But Kemp got doubled on by Divots and Webber. Shot clock now comes to 10. Slashing to the ball. He got it up on the glass. Divots stripped it away. Numbers run. Sacramento. That's Brevin Knight on the personal foul. Jason Williams wanted to go to the hoop.
On a consistent basis.
We are tied at 19 apiece. This is Kemp on the block. Sean against Chris Webber. Webber rejected it. Kemp got it back. Tried to find Lamon Murray inside. Shot clock is at 5. Surafon Murray. With a huge emphatic dunk.
Against the Sacramento Kings defense, you can get half penetration or penetration all the way to the rim just about every offensive possession, and then either draw a defender or find an open man, as Sura did there
for Lamon Murray. Orlis Williamson trying to back down on Murray. Swung inside, and that's a triangle on Williamson. Get away the hoop. Lamon Murray threw down two of these huge dunks last night in the early going as he went 6 for 6 for 14 points in Boston.
Yeah, he has a sneaky extension. You don't think he delivered too far away from the basket. That wasn't so much extension there. He was on that
point. Lamon Murray with a quick two-handed punch cleaning up Bob Sura's reverse. Williams got caught in the air and found Divots. Nick Anderson to unload the three. He's going to come up wide left, and all the swings continue. For Slick Nick. Murray flying into the hole. Oh, Murray captivating the gun here in the opening quarter. Three straight slammers by Lamon Murray. All a little bit different, but all crowd pleasing to be sure. Webber with a step back jumper that's right there. Chris Webber with a dozen. This is nothing but pushing up for both clubs. Sura to triple. Yeah. Making it two as Bobby got a foot on the air.
Myself.
Bob Sura, as is his one for an 8-point first quarter. Webber to get Sean Kemp to play it. Not this time. Williamson to run it down. Seawalker. That Divots for the quick deuce.
Whoever can do so well. That's why it almost seems like a wasted possession for him to take one dribble, settle for a long jump shot. He can just do so many more things for himself and for the team.
Sean Kemp going to give Brevin Knight an opportunity. Back heel with Kemp slapped it away from Weber. Sura the trigger. Not a very good defensive team. I'm going to show you why. Cavaliers 4-5 from home run range. Bob Sura has triple three times. Good luck from Jason Williams. Left hand for Nick Anderson that fell.
A rare shot attempt for Nick Anderson.
Comfortable, Maddie. Maybe that's going to continue to come in the flow of what the Cavaliers are trying to do. Bob Sura to turn the corner. Sean Kemp will tee it up and knock it down.
Well, the Sacramento defense has to compress so much because they can't guard anybody off the dribble that it's leaving wide open jump shots. And then when they do show up too high now, that's when you get those dunk opportunities.
Lottie Divots lost the basketball. Cavaliers have a 4-on-1 run. Sean Kemp, they're right in the rim. They're getting anything they want.
Now, I did mention that the Sacramento Kings have a very good bench. It usually bails them out, but look at them and trying to show a lot of patience here with his starters, giving them a chance to try to do something good before he starts to take it.
Nick Anderson will splash a three. Got to feel good, Nick Anderson, because as we said, only 30% from three-point range this year, 35% from four. Cavalier lead is 6. Andre Miller on the floor now. He's replaced Brevin Knight. Cedric Henderson is going to get up, and that's going to be for Lamon Murray.
Number 45, Cedric Henderson.
Lamon Murray will hear it from the Cavalier crowd as he sits down with his very thunderous 9-point beginning tonight. It's Andre Miller with Bob Sura, Sean Kennedy.
Let's stand 2 minutes remaining.
And Cedric Henderson.
Like I said, I know how he thinks, but I can appreciate the problems he's going through right now, and I also appreciate how he can get out of those problems.
Bob Sura is going to jack up another triple that drops. Sura.
shot or a pass? Where's the other?
Kept thinking about it over Chris Webber. Inside a minute left in the opening quarter. Entertaining to say the least. Cavaliers by six. Williams with a hesitation. And threw it right through Paulus Williamson. How difficult is it for an athlete when Jason Williams comes into your system to get used to him and play in concert with him?
Obviously, it's difficult for this team right now because he's averaging close to four turnovers a game, which, you know, some of them are unforced on his part. Some of them are players just not ready for his quick passes. But when you're playing with a guy like Jason Williams, you've got to have your hands up and ready in the catch position at all times because you're about to break your nose.
Bob Sura running off the curl. This is Mark Hendrickson. And Bill Blair was telling us he likes the looks of the 6'9 athlete out of Washington State.
You always bring a Wally Pip.
I've just figured that out. West person with a clean look. Cavaliers look like they continue to get any kind of good shot that they want. However, this second unit for the Sacramento Kings is a much better defensive unit. Now, got some holes out there. Stojakovic, Florence Funderburk, long 6'9" with a left hand that fell. He powered his way to the front of the rim. West person to triple. Back rim. The hands of Andrew McClurk, offensive board, Cavaliers. Miller has picked things up once again. Coming off the bench. This is Cedric Henderson. Cedric starts 0 for 2 in his bench minutes tonight. Eric Martin, a little left-hander, played with the LA Clippers. He's out of UCLA in the sixth NBA season.
That's me!
Weber fell the trap coming. John Barry shot off the floor. For Sacramento, and that's the kind of shot that they have to settle for. Best person not able to triple, but Andrew DeFerro's got the effect it goes. He has earned some minutes now. Remember Andy Whitman's rotation? Said Henderson baseline. His jumper a little bit shy, but Lawrence Funderburk's got an offensive board. This is Derek Martin. Rick to three. Andre Miller, up tempo. Andre Miller, flying to the hole. Plus one more coming from the line on the foul from Derek Martin. Well, on some of the poorer shots of the Sacramento Kings, as the one put up right there, one brick hard off the glass, almost starting the fast break with the rebound coming off so hard. And the Kings very slow in getting back on defense. And this is duck soup for the Cavaliers. They love to get out and run early at home. That has been evident all year long. Cavaliers 4 of 8 here in the second. Stolen away, Seth Henderson. A solo and a throwdown from Cedric. The end ball boy with the mop there actually played a little better defense than the Kings. He made Cedric slow up just a little bit.
John Jr.
Back to Divac on Bryant. Body's going to back it out of there. Jason Williams, tremendous look inside. And he found that bounce pass to Tony Dell, who dropped it down. Rick Adelman has already gone 12 deep now. As he's trying to find anybody that can play well. That was an ooh and ah type pass from Jason Williams. He's good for about 4 or 5 of those games. Bounce pass extraordinaire. Shot clock at 8. Sir will cross over. Bobby found went through his hands and out of bounds. Turnover count. Too hot to handle. Too close and only about 8 feet away to throw that hard an aerial pass. Very difficult for Lamont Murray to catch it. Chris Webber is going to go back rim with that jumper. Tony Dell could bring it down. Webber inside the reverse powered it home. Chris Webber is 16. Bob Sura flying into the hole. Oh, yeah. And one more coming from the line. Cavaliers. Kings are 7 out of 9 from the line. A couple of misses for Lamont Murray. Jason Williams firing off the glass. And Chris Webber went and cleaned it up and spiked it home. Well, he thought Webber was going to go for the alley-oop. Webber stopped on him, which is something you should never do to a passer, but the pass was perfectly off the backboard. I'm sure not able to finish. Lynch off a baseline reverse, and D-Box wants it in the hands of Jason Williams. Williams the raise up and run up a long three.
They'll do plenty of that any from distance.
This is just exactly how they get back into games. I think. There's a lot of talent out there.
You got Jason Williams, Chris Webber, D-Box.
Robin Knight left his jumper short. Is down to 10. Let me come inside. 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Left here in the opening half. Weber at that free throw line against Sean Kemp. He's going to lift it over the top of Sean. That ends a Sacramento 10-0 run. Cavaliers by 10 again. A minute and 10 left in this opening half. Jason Williams, tee up a three that drops. Really excellent pass out of the double team from Chris Webber, and that's why you wonder why he doesn't approach deep as much as possible to create open shots for teammates. Ahmad Murray now being doubled. Jason Williams got a steal as he stepped in. Williams will raise up. Got a rip, another three. He's feeling it. Jason Williams and the Sacramento Kings will put a 17-point lead down to four.
Didn't I say I don't think he should be taking those threes?
Yeah. Oh, Jason Williams, expressive.
Keep in mind, 28% from downtown. He could care less about what he's shooting from the field. He's only shooting 36% from the field. He's going to shoot it when he feels it, which is just about every time he crosses half court.
That's Sacramento up. Revan Knight wants Sean Kemp in that low left block. Jason Williams helping with Sean's in no man's land. The winner took it away. All of a sudden, the Cavaliers have come undone in the half court.
Too much pounding of the ball, too much holding.
Speaking of holding, shot clock and game clock just about synced up. Jason Williams, the triple, left this one short. Kemp will leak out. Short to the ball, that puts it with some emphasis.
Well, that's what happens. Long shots result into long rebounds and easy breakaway lay-ins.
Jason Williams. Went back rim. It has been a very explosive first 24 minutes of basketball. The Cavaliers 17-point lead shrinks to six. First pass went to a couple of folks, several young fans in the third row.
And Bob Sir thought that Ahmad Murray was going to keep on going there, but a careless possession.
And Anderson will stroke a deep three. And the Cavalier lead is down to two. It's 63-61. Sir out at that three-point arc. Sean Kemp with some power. Oh, the left hand never got it. Sir up penetrating. Mark Bryant. Another possession. Cavaliers. Sir kept it alive. Sir.
Oh!
Lit on the hoop. Three-on-one run out. Jason Williams. Paulus Williamson. Sacramento with their first lead since 2-0.
That looked like the Sacramento team defense in the first quarter. Nobody getting back quickly enough. So the Kings.
Cavaliers very disheveled right now on the offensive end. Jason Williams. Nola pass to Colin Williamson who went off glass. And Sacramento has gone from 17 down to take a 4-point lead at 69-65.
But the Cavaliers have helped the Kings, especially at the start of this third quarter. You used the word a little bit while ago, disheveled offense. It's worse than that. They came out launching jump shots and they had nothing going. They tried to do backward Andre Miller and kind of Wesley Person.
Bryant's pass never got to Sean. Kept that high hand off from Jason Williams. Chris Webber with a big punch. Weber with 26. He's done it on 12 of 27 from the floor. Sean Kemp. When it comes undone like this, everybody just searches for answers.
And once again, poor transition defense, although I don't know how you guard people 3 or 4 feet over the rim.
Importantly, tonight, Sean Kemp and Ahmad Murray also involved. Lawrence Thunderbird with that left-handed step back
jumper. I think he's going to be a very good player in this league. He reminds me of a lot of things that Chris Gatling is able to do as an offensive player. Good enough to shoot that medium distance jumper and good enough to get inside and create a lot of havoc for the defense. Nice ball. I like the comparison to Gatling. Shot clock at 8. Andre Miller turned the corner. Cavaliers looking a little bit out of sorts as Andrew DeClercq misfired on the jumper. No flow in that set. Kind of go back to Andre Miller, get the ball in his hands, and let him create at this point. Thunderbird taking it on Mark Bryant. Got some help from Andrew DeClercq over the top. Very careful left block. Sir on the step through. And full hit, got it upright in front of his forehead, whipped it over, two hands overperformed. And I think the booze were, why take him out of the game with these points away? Mon Murray split the pair, the lead is 3 at 92-89. Weber and Kemp are really badly on the block. Griffin Wright is back and almost got a strip away. Shot clock will come. The 5. Jason Williams fouled Thunderbird. He took a hit from Sean Kemp. Williams is so crafty and shows you the basketball and then gets rid of the basketball, and his passes are accurate in traffic.
Well, you know, again, don't even want to comparing him to Larry Bird or Magic Johnson, except in this vein, in that those kinds of players, and there's not that many in the whole wide world, they're a step or two ahead with their mental processes as far as what's going to develop ahead. And he is so quick with his body movements and so quick with his hands, strong with his hands, he's able to deliver the ball. He sees things happening before they actually happen. And when I say Bird and Magic, they certainly were able to do that.
Very good point. And remember, you're talking about delivering. He delivered the football to Randy Moss in their high school days. Juwan High School in West Virginia. Sean Kemp looked like he was going to roll to the hoop, and Lamon Murray went over the top of his head. Stojakovic trying to step through. Jason Williams turning the corner, flipped it up in the glass. Cavaliers got a run out. Free throw line, family three. 97-93, the lead is 4. Thunderbird tying up Kemp on the low block. Sean Wheeling baseline. Found Andrew DeClercq, who went blast with the left hand and got the roll. Andrew DeClercq finished it off.
Nice drop walk pass by Sean Kemp.
97-95, still 5 minutes left. A lot of basketball. Jason Williams looking at Thunderbird. Shot clock is set. Thunderbird to lift it and knock it down. Lawrence Thunderbird connecting. Lead back up to 4 again. Sura doubled on the baseline. Sura to trip. Come up short. Into the hands of Chris Weber. 35 points and 9 rebounds for Weber.
Well, one of the things you'd like to see the Cavaliers do in this situation, you've got Jason Williams with 4 fouls. Now, Brevin Knight's not going to post him up or isolate him, but at least the environment in some pick-and-roll situations to make him defend or not defend.
Swing from Williams to Pages Stojakovic on the step through. Sir had a piece. Shot clock at 2. That won't get there. And that's a 24-second violation. Shot defensively by Bob Sura as Mark Bryant will come back to replace Andrew DeClercq.
Stojakovic has had just a miserable night, unable to get anything going. He's billed as a perimeter shooter. He's been somewhat streaky in that area, but very dangerous. But I'm a little surprised that Rick Adelman has stayed so long with Stojakovic.
played a lot in this fourth quarter. Sean Kemp to raise up. Kemp was 17. Sacramento the lead is 2. You got to dig in defensively. Look for your stop. So if you get a good stop, by that I mean a good hard rebound or steal, you're going to look to go out and get easy baskets so you don't have to just rely on your half court. Mason Williams will kick. Stojakovic raising up. Landis fired the 3. Ron Murray to rip it away. Cavaliers can try in this trip. Mark Bryant. That took a little time to get into it, but got a good look, a good pass with Sean Kemp being fronted. Perfect pass, actually. And Sean wrapped up pretty tight there. Almost impossible to go up hard and strong in that fashion. Sean Kemp 2 for 5 from the line tonight, so he'll look to split the pair and hold the Cavs to 1. Cavs looking to Randy River to see if they should foul no matter what happens on this situation. Randy wants a lot of pressure, and I think that they'll decide now because there is about three and a half second differential. Put some pressure on, try to get a steal. Going to put a good foul shooter in his third. John Barry about 80% right on the free throw line.
It's 3 on Bob Sura, so Barry hits them both. The Cavaliers will be down by 3 with these 25.9 seconds left.
Bobby was the first one to turn around and ask Randy if he wanted a foul right away. Randy said, no, let's put pressure on, and then we'll see as they bring the ball up the floor.
Certainly in pretty strong control right now. John Barry followed by Wes Person. John Barry's going to get right back to the line, and a couple of free throws here would quite conceivably be the final game.
I know the college rule is it's actually a technical foul, 2 free throws, and you lose possession. It's been so rare that it's ever called in the NBA. I remember years ago, remember the famous triple overtime Phoenix and Boston where Gar Herb hit the long jump shot, yes, for one of those overtime? Actually, there was a timeout, illegal timeout called in that game. Richie Powers was the referee and pretended that he didn't see it.
Hits a couple. So for the Cavaliers, it's about happened every way conceivable during this string of losing 9 and 10. Red Knight's going to turn it all the way to the hoop. Sean Kemp.
Get out!
Slide out of his hands before he put it back home. If this one turns out the way it's looking right now, before they welcome in Golden State on Thursday.
Now, I don't know, Michael, if the players have had a players-only meeting. Normally, when you're going through losing streaks, losing 9 out of 10, this would be 10 out of 11. You normally have those. Sometimes they're productive. They're generally shouting sessions, somewhat finger-pointed, but it does air out a lot of things and heighten the awareness of a lot of different situations and can be helpful. And this is one of his... John Barry's a smart player.
Bob Sura at the free throw strike. Bob Sura hits some balls. 111 to 107. And this one is going to expire. That's it. The Cavaliers have dropped their 10th of their last 11 as the Sacramento Kings win for the first time since 1984 in Cleveland.